In 2003, around Thanksgiving, a young girl, 7 years old, named Samantha Reckes, started not feeling well. She was running a fever about 102. Her father bought some children's Motrin and gave her a couple of doses according to what the label said. Within about 48 hours, she was covered head to toe in blisters. Her eyes and her mouth were completely glued shut with mucus and blisters. When she got to Mass General, she was that evening diagnosed with toxic epidermal necrolysis, a severe adverse drug reaction. All of her skin, from the top of her head to her feet, essentially burned off. And in Samantha, it rendered her completely blind. She had lost 80% of her lung capacity as a result of high levels of medication. She had liver failure. She then had a stroke, an aneurysm, had to have brain surgery. And when she was finally discharged to rehabilitation, she, at 7 years old, weighed about 30 pounds. The case was based on Johnson & Johnson's knowledge since the late 1980s that ibuprofen, their brand is Children's Motrin, has a causal connection to Stevens-Johnson syndrome and to toxic epidermal necrolysis. And the question was, why wasn't Johnson & Johnson warning about this? Every once in a while, a case comes along where you cannot, for the life of you, figure out why your opponent is behaving the way they are. This was one of those cases. We did not understand why they could not recognize that this poor child and her family had suffered so much and that it was so clearly related to their product. But Johnson & Johnson wanted to make a change in the law of preemption in the United States, and they wanted to use this case to do it. Essentially, they were arguing that the FDA approved our label and therefore we are no longer responsible for its content. The problem with that is that in 2009, the U.S. Supreme Court decided, no, pharmaceutical companies, you are responsible for your label. You are the one that is following the drug and seeing the reactions and getting the adverse event reports and learning about how it's affecting people out there in the world. That was what Johnson & Johnson was after in this case. They wanted to knock down that component of preemption. The vice president of marketing for McNeil, Johnson & Johnson's wholly owned subsidiary, testified that when warnings are added to the label, sales go down. And so it is the classic case of profits over people. I've talked to a lot of doctors over the years. Very few of them knew that ibuprofen could cause SJS-10. And to the extent we've been able to educate any of those doctors, that was an impact, and that may be the greatest impact we could make. This is a story about how a 7-year-old girl can be knocked down by a giant and get up, fight the giant for 13 years, and in the end, defeat the giant.